Water concessionaire Maynilad seeking to implement a staggered rate increase of 13 pesos from 2023 to 2027 for its mandatory rate rebasing. The proposed rate hike will begin with 3 pesos and 29 centavos next year. Maynilad says the company is targeting to spend about 150 billion pesos for the next 5 years on its water and wastewater projects. Rate rebasing is conducted every 5 years under the concession agreement of Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System with water concessionaires. But concessionaires are subject to a performance review.
Inflation adjustment lang po pwede sila sa first year. Yung kanilang mga rate rebasing adjustments starting second year po. At ito po ay, again, conditional. Na kailangan po maayos po nila ang kanilang serbisyo bago po nila pwedeng i-claim ito. Pag hindi po nila maayos, pwede po ma-defer ito until maayos po nila.
Small businesses encouraged to utilize the internet to scale their businesses and in turn help the Philippine economy grow further. Jackie Pascual reports.
Glenda Manuson is intently listening to the speakers at the Digital Sign Up Now Summit in Pasay organized by Go Negosyo. She started a gourmet food business at the start of the pandemic, and now she wants to learn to expand it.
Gusto ko pong matutunan na how to promote my business digitally kasi yung time ko po is hindi ako masyadong techie.
The summit aims to help small and medium-sized businesses scale up with the help of the online world. Go Negosyo founder Joey Concepcion says, entrepreneurs must learn to utilize the internet and social media correctly in order to help their businesses.
In accessing the open platforms, Shopee, Lazada, and so many others, no, even in the food platforms, you will have to know how to market it. It's not enough that you put your product there, or else it will not move.
Concepcion, whose family owns a large corporation, says he too is learning from the young speakers because big businesses also need to adapt to the new strategies in marketing and product development.
Us, in this older generation, are learning that language because for us, it's very important for us even to be able to market our product in that manner because that's the growing market today.
The U.S. Embassy in Manila, which co-organizes the event, stresses the need to go digital properly, especially for small businesses. The Philippine Information and Communications Technology Department is also pushing for this effort as this will also open up more jobs.
The digital economy is a whole new spectrum of entrepreneurial opportunity. This spans the globe and all demographics across the Philippines. It is transforming how we live, work, play, travel, and socialize.
Help the government and we're able to empower more jobs, more livelihood. Magdagdag po tayo ng mga trabaho, magdagdag ng negosyo sa ating mga kilala sa ating community.
Go Negosyo believes various social media sites are changing the landscape and businesses must learn to ride with the changes as this may make the Philippines a more inclusive country. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. meets with members of the Filipino Chamber of Commerce of Hawaii. During a courtesy call in Malacañang, Marcos recalled the kindness of the Filipino community in Hawaii back in 1986 when their family was exiled there after his father's ouster from power. The Marcos family fled to Hawaii after the 1986 People Power Revolution until the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. died in 1989. Marcos then discussed his initiatives to keep the growth momentum of the country post-pandemic with FCCH members. The FCCH is considered one of the largest Filipino chambers in the U.S., providing support to Filipino entrepreneurs in Hawaii.